Hey, yo. 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 Hey, yo.
All right, for a minute there, I thought we lost it.
Is enough to get me to the boiling point. Even though I knew exactly how you felt about me, Macho Man, at this point, I was letting everything slide, brother. I was just hoping that that cancer... And as you start to lose your grasp, as your fingers start to slide down the front of the belt, that's when I'm gonna strip it away from you.
Remember when you were making out with your first girlfriend, and you came right as she touched your leg? It was me, Barry. I jerked you off at super speed so it'd seem like you nutted at just a woman's touch! It's me, Barry. I made them draw Lola Bunny with fewer sexual features so that you wouldn't be horny and reduce your blood flow to make you a millisecond slower.
I got you a gift. I know it's a little bit early, but... It just came in. Nah, it just came in. I figured I'd give it to you now.
This.
It's Big Chungus.
What is Big Chungus?
Do you like it?
I don't even have a PS4. What is Big Chungus? Is this a joke?
It's free real estate.
Great job.
Kids, would you step outside for a second?
Fiddle-dee-dee!
What is up?
Fiddle-dee-dee!
Fiddle-dee-dee! What's up, everybody? What's up, everybody in the chat? I gotta pop my chat out so I can see what people are saying. We got some people here already. Brandon.
What's up?
How was your day? I went to the dentist today.
Yeah, you went to the dentist. I saw the Cosmic Ballet.
Oh, yeah, there is a Cosmic Ballet of sorts was going on today.
You should have played that clip from The Simpsons.
I
like the PAX TV version of Homer swearing, always funny. But Leonard Nimoy saying the Cosmic Ballet goes.
Yeah, there was an eclair in the sky.
Delicious.
It was succulent, and you and I both watch it. Some of the people at the office were too cool to watch it.
That was the dumbest thing. It was so dumb.
But wait, there's more.
Buzz, did you watch the proceedings of the Cosmic Ballet today?
No, I was one of those cool people that didn't want to watch it.
Oh my god.
Weird. It was cooler to see it.
I'm tired of these office edgelords ignoring the eclipse.
It was me. They were like, hey, here's some glasses. I slapped them down. I was like, get out of here, geek.
No, I want to keep looking at the same thing I do every day of my life.
No, I was on my phone. I wasn't even paying attention. Screw that.
Someone in the office today didn't have glasses, but he had PT today.
PT? Oh yeah, he had physical therapy.
He had physical therapy, and then he canceled his physical therapy appointment because he couldn't find Eclipse glasses. And he ran to the 7-Eleven. They were all sold out. And then he ran to, I don't know where else. But he couldn't find them. Turns out we had 4 pairs at the office.
Yeah. You know what? I didn't even look for this. But this is true. The shadows of certain things are crescent-shaped, you know, because of the pattern of the sunlight coming down, right? I wonder if that's why everything looked so especially weird right at, like, the maximum point of the eclipse.
Maximum.
When we went to go get coffee was at the peak maximum time for the eclipse. It was not just dark out. There was something visibly wrong with the lighting. And I wonder if it was because the light was crescent shaped and I didn't pay enough attention to it.
Remember last year this happened. And I don't think we were able to see it, but
It was cloudy as hell.
House sent me text messages, and he's like, look at the shadows of the leaves from these trees, and they were all freaking weird. They're like circular. I didn't notice any of that.
Now we got like 96% coverage or something over here. It was over 95% coverage. It looked really, really cool. But yeah, we didn't get the whole thing. I was excited because I can't remember ever experiencing a solar eclipse that I've witnessed. Because the last time it was over here in 2017 or something like that, it was even more further north than this one. So it would have been even better. But the weather was just absolute trash. This time it was completely open sky. It was gorgeous out.
Yeah, it was an awesome day. But unlike yesterday was super rainy, but it was like 70 out, really nice weather, nice sun, good sky, blue sky.
Got dark and cold out, that's crazy.
Fiddly D's in the chat. What's up, Dale A? We got Richie Dupier, Snuggy Jr., Crazy Mad, Oz. Is this old Oz? Which Oz is this? Oh, look, he's got that Bisley freaking body count cover as his avatar. Hail.
That's not Kevin Nash.
No, it's not Kevin Nash. Damn it. This is Nash. Eddie Winkler in the chat. I just saw him yesterday.
In real life. In Japan. You know, I did just see. Damn, I hope I liked it.
Probably
gone. I saw a map, a global map of all of the next upcoming trajectories for the next eclipses. We should have showed that was pretty cool.
I'm not too worried about it. They'll tell us on the news.
Aldous
is here. Good to see you, Aldous. Henry Bemis, Jay Ryan. Gone
forever.
What's that noise?
It's a hovercraft outside.
They're landing finally.
The ninjas are getting on a bike to attack our Brandon.
It's the cosmic demons that swallowed the sun today.
Yeah,
what if they swallowed the sun but then replaced it with a fake sun?
I was thinking about this while it was happening. So you know how like there's all the like tribal and like ancient situation, like they think that the sun is being swallowed by a snake and the world is going to end and stuff like mm-hmm. that. And like our eclipse from the very beginning of it to the end of it was only 2 hours, right? And like I was thinking, like, imagine you being so freaked out for 2 hours, the earth is going to end, everything's going to die, and then 2 hours go by and nothing happened. Like, pretty anti-climax.
Fine. It's like, oh, we sacrificed my niece for no reason.
That's probably what it was. They probably, like, confirmation bias, right? They killed whatever to sacrifice it, and then they were like, oh, look, we stopped it.
Exactly. Yeah, I wouldn't be that's no good. Yeah. I went to the dentist, and the dentist, what do you call a lady that cleans secretary. Teeth. No, she's not the secretary. She's not even the dentist. She just cleans teeth.
I think a dental technician.
Right? Yeah, so Dentech. I don't remember her name. But she was saying, she's like, oh, these young
dental hygienist. Yeah,
right. Dental hygienist. She's like, these youngsters are, I'm hearing that in some town that has a really small police force, they had to send like the narcos from a bigger town to go over there because everybody's saying that opioids have a bigger effect on the body during the eclipse. Like, what? I don't know about any of that, but
do you think though, because I brush my teeth multiple times a day
and she huffed more laughing gas.
Take care of the hygiene of my teeth.
She's like, you don't mind if I take my head, do you?
Yeah. No, I'm good.
Dental hygienist is kind of a misnomer. I feel like I'm a dental hygienist.
All right, you clean the teeth every day.
Right. I'm the one cleaning the teeth.
Mm-hmm. What's she doing then? I should
be called a dental hygienist.
She's like taking all those small barbs off your teeth that no one could see.
What?
Yeah, they're all like, oh, there's these like little tiny, like marrow from Joe Mad's X-Men. There's like those tiny bones sticking out of you, but instead of sticking out of this chick from X-Men with pink hair, they're sticking out of your teeth and they got to break them off.
I've never done that.
That's what,
break them off, you know, when I'm eating a nice fettuccine Alfredo at Olive Garden and I bite down on the fork, that's when that breaks off on my teeth.
Yeah, that sounds horrible. No, those little hooks, the dental hooks. Uh-huh. That, no, this is what she told me. She's like, the dental hooks, she's putting it around the teeth and she's breaking the...
Yeah, this is similar to when you got that gold
bar
thing and you're supposed to poke your gums and it's just shooting blood like a Kill Bill action sequence.
Right? Yeah, it should be. Is it still in there? It should be up there. Yeah, let's share your piece on YouTube.
We're going to get...
They gave me this gold probe, yeah, right, at the dentist years ago. Is that it?
Yeah.
Yeah, why don't you try it out on stream?
Well, what do you want to get taken down for? Showing a firearm or showing blood shooting out of somebody's
face? Mouth? Yeah, since you gave me that, and it's called gum. Stimulation.
Stimulator.
And it's like this rubbery pick, and then... All she's like, oh yeah, you just poke yourself in the gums for what? I don't even know why.
Let's see what it says here. Place rubber tip between teeth and apply light pressure in a circular motion to massage the gums. Repeat what? From tooth to tooth.
It sounds like she wants you to do her job. No wonder she's not.
Yeah, I'm not the dental hygienist.
Exactly.
It's your job.
Replacing the rubber tip.
Dentists are some of the most miserable people. I don't know. I don't even know if they're dentists.
Did you use this, Phil?
Yeah, that one time, and then my gums started bleeding instantly.
It's got a rubber tip that's not unlike a piece of plastic, pointy plastic that would hurt a lot.
Yeah, so you're supposed to place it like in your the armpit of your gum in between your teeth. It's the rubber tips for...
You know, next time you go, check her credentials. Make sure she's legit. Because this is sound kind of sus right now.
Look, everybody's been talking about the eclipse today, right? We needed something different on the show.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, it's a new ecliptic cycle, which I just made up right now. You're the dragon.
Mm.
The dragon has now eaten the sun and digested it and given rebirth to the sun again. If you listen to that Chinese mumbo jumbo. See, Snuggy Jr. Dental Extraordinaire helps build up colossus on your gums. I love Peter Rasputin. Pretty cool. Hashtag just the eclipse.
I enjoyed the eclipse.
Yeah, I enjoyed it too. I was happy to have been able to see it.
Yeah, so I don't use that thing anymore. Everybody should floss.
Well, an awesome one saying flossing is bad for your teeth. I heard from a dentist that you're only supposed to floss the teeth that you want to keep.
That makes sense. No, it's not. So flossing is bad for your teeth? It's not about the teeth. It's about the gums.
I thought it was about Big Floss selling more floss. It's good for the floss companies.
First, Big Gum tries to get to buy you their weapons, and now Big Gum. This is getting outrageous, man.
Big Gun and Big Gum?
Yes, Big Gum. But
probably owned by the same company.
Yeah, probably. Yes. Umbrella Corp.
So that's what happened today. Brandon, is the Blaster Brother drawn any more sexy art?
Ooh.
No, I haven't drawn anything since that last Bikini Girl.
I drew something.
Oh, my God. You drew blood by poking your gums with this stimulator. This now, I haven't gotten around to it because I have Exotica convention this weekend, and then anything that I would draw right now wouldn't be ready for sale at the show, you know? So, plus I've been organizing my art and then counting stuff and ordering new prints to replace ones that I've sold at other shows. So I've just been focusing on that for right now, but get back to it afterward. I got to keep doing the Bikini Girls until we're out of this winter phase. And then when we get into spring, I'll probably just keep doing the Bikini Girls because I enjoy it.
Isn't it spring?
Yeah, we've been in spring for the last 2 months.
Oh, my God. All right. We got... Oh, wait. We have a new... We're going to use the old one here.
Get that ugly, disabled freak away from me.
We got Chimera here.
Hello.
Hello. The first
man Chimera hybrid. What's up? You want to see my drawing, Chimera?
I'd rather see Brandon's drawings. It has more asses.
All right. Well, this last week I drew.
I'll show you the picture of Goku.
Jake's character. Brandon, did you see this? You probably didn't see this. I drew Jake's character, Carnal the Barbarian.
Ooh, Maximum Carnal.
Oh, dude, he should totally do a Maximum Carnal.
He's failed already by not having done that.
There you go.
That honestly looks like Jake drew it. So you draw the same as Jake. Actually, that's slightly better because it has more.
Oh my God.
More facial hair. I won't stand for this.
No, they're already saying Kate Chimera. That's a record. So you're not for
30 seconds. I'll show Chimera a drawing, but
it's a Rambo reference.
Yeah, I could see it's a First Blood reference.
Yeah, it says they drew first Coom.
Oh, thank you.
You know, you should totally do a Rambo comic, but not
do a Maximum Carnal. He's Rambo.
Oh yeah. Hmm. There you go. What'd you draw?
I didn't draw. I drew this a long time ago. I'll show him because he's a weeb. I'll just show him my Goku draw.
Oh wow.
Yeah, isn't that good?
Yeah, it's like the first time I've seen you not draw tits.
Exactly.
Well, except Magic Cop, but
yeah.
Wow. I did that.
Now you hurt Brandon.
A long time ago. And now my feelings are hurt.
See, people are saying garbage. The knife is disgustingly close to his mouth. Yeah, I started the with the arm first because I just based it off of the that fish from The Simpsons. What's that fish called?
Flying hellfish.
Hellfish. And then his head, and then his hand was here, and then the knife had to go up. So it was a mistake.
Yeah, I should keep only drawing women, I know.
But Jake already promised to print that in his sketchbook. So it'll be published. Brandon hid boobs in the clouds?
Maybe. Probably a subconscious thing. I don't know.
Osmos, it's time to start PhilCast about how awful Phil's drawing is. You got a couple weeks out of that. Yeah, so welcome to the show. This is The Hardline. We've been doing this for 192 episodes tonight, every Monday. The first CG Monday show. Don't let anybody tell you different. Been doing it for years now. In a couple weeks, was it 8 weeks? We're going to be at show 200. I think that's when we're going to cancel it. It's a good time to cancel it.
That's right. No, you should go out at 199. Keep them waiting for 200.
Oh, and then just be like, yeah, we'll come back next week.
We're on yeah, 200 is coming soon. And just never do it.
Yeah, Hardline Dental episode. It is Monday. Yeah, we got some stuff to talk about. Oh, this weekend was WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm.
Did you, Edwin, did you watch WrestleMania?
No.
Well, you know who wasn't on WrestleMania? These two guys. Scissor me, Daddy! Neither was Shelby. What's up, Shelby?
What's going on, dude? How you doing?
Did you have a class today?
I never have class.
Without you don't have glasses. What's going on here?
Yeah, I never have glass.
Did you break your glass?
No, I was
probably misses his old glasses.
Did you get new glasses?
No, I just like not wearing them, so I don't have to read chat.
Uh-huh.
Dude, I like not wearing my glasses too.
Does your wife prefer you not to wear glasses?
I don't think she prefers me.
It's a real battle axe, that one. Let's see.
It's all ball and no chain.
Just glassing. Shelby is like school on Sunday.
Damn. That's when you cuss. When you get caught cussing in class, you get Sunday school.
Dude. By class.
Saturday school, actually.
By
class. Superhero with glasses.
Almost. I'm like half a point away from... I'm gonna get bifocals.
Bifocals? I'm a real nerd.
Nerd. Shelby, do you have any dentist stories? Yeah, give me your best dentist story.
no, I don't have any good dentist stories.
Well, Shelby William Shatner waiting in the dental waiting.
Yes. Room. Yeah, there was that one time. I ran into Leonard Nimoy
in
the bathroom at my dentist office. Yeah,
I get them confused sometimes.
Yeah, this is absolutely true. No, I did a kid's book for a dental office, and a Crest bought it. You guys don't know, you could buy it on Amazon, and I'm not even going to tell you the link because I don't want you to own it. It's a kid's book, dude. It's not a comic, so I don't.
Was really... it like a tooth superhero?
It's about bad guy bacteria that eat teeth.
I want to read
it's a book about how there's you need Shelby to brush
Robertson
it.
Completionists out there, and they need this dental book.
Get it and post about it on Twitter.
Someone
my photo on the back is me eating.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go find this post. Dentist permanently damaged my jaw when I was 11. Jesus, that's horrible.
Did you get punched?
The dentist punched him in the face?
Yeah.
Dude, I basically got punched in the face by my dog earlier, but with his head. I thought I was going to bruise, but I'm good. Crest Fights Cavity Creeps. Is that the book?
No.
He took a little while to respond to there.
Yeah.
Hesitant.
Suspicious.
No.
No, it came out in 02, 01 or 02, I think.
You order it through Diamond.
No, you could get it through Barnes & Noble, though. Yeah, elementary schools got it. The libraries did, not like the whole school. And then, Barnes & Noble actually had it. He did a signing and asked me if I wanted to do a signing out in Modesto, California, and up in Oakland. I was like, no. And then he punched me in the face and broke my jaw.
Well, everybody hunt that down. I want to know about it and DM me.
Yeah, good luck.
So today we are streaming on YouTube, on X, and on Rumble. And we actually have the most Rumblers we've had in a long time. This is almost 10. We got about 8 Rumblers over there. Good to see you guys. We have 59 on Twitter and 45 on YouTube. Appreciate you guys being here.
Big if true.
Big. It's already big. So what we have, the WrestleMania was yesterday.
Spoilers.
Yeah, spoilers, if you guys didn't know. Cody Rhodes won the championship against the Bloodline, Roman Reigns. I'm sure nobody in the chat cares. But Brandon said this to me, and I thought this was funny. This is when he was looking up Dusty Rhodes.
Yeah.
Rhodes, baby. What did you think of the show, Buzz? Did you watch it?
He said
no. No, it was a complete mid from the highlights that I saw. It was nonsense.
Damn.
You didn't like the John Cena coming out and then The Rock coming out?
Yeah.
No, John Cena come back like every 4 months. Like,
oh, wait. Then The Undertaker coming out.
Yes, for no reason. The Undertaker just decided to come out of retirement again for the first.
See, I think it shouldn't have been Undertaker. It should have been Goldust. Goldust comes out, gets retribution, saves his brother, and his brother goes on to winning the championship.
Here's an idea. Cody out-wrestles Roman and beats him clean in the middle of the ring and wins the title, proving he's the best. That's shocking, you know, and it's kind of out there for.
I agree. During the match, remember, Brendan, I'm like, all of this stuff happening, did Cody even really win this belt?
Right, yeah.
There was so many interference.
It ruined the the whole mystique behind him winning.
Yeah, it's like he put a cheat code in, and he's God mode now, and everybody, all of his buddies are coming in.
Waiting for Hogan to come in and rescue him.
Yeah.
They didn't do that.
Hogan make it to past the ramp. You know, he'd probably pull a hip or something.
Brandon had a good twist, you know, because the Bloodline is there, Roman Reigns' family, all those big Samoan guys. Tell them your idea, Brandon.
Well, I was going to say about this one here, I loved when The Rock really shoved it in Cena's face, saying that at least one of us could admit that we're bald.
Yeah, there's a bald spot. Well, I did see the bald spot as well.
So, yeah, there was the big bald off on in the ring there. But yeah, I wanted her to be like the American Bloodline to come out. You know, you get like Hogan coming out, you know, the real American hero.
American flag comes out.
Phil was saying Jack Swagger would come out.
Yeah, and his
Jim Duggan.
Yeah, everybody.
You're talking about go hardcore American. IRS is back. Comes back.
No, who's the American... Who's Buff Bagwell's
angle?
Sergeant Slaughter.
Oh, yeah. Slaughter comes out. The Edward Hughes, Buff Bagwell's tag team. The American...
American Males. Yeah, Scotty American Riggs. Males.
Yeah. And it's the American Bloodline versus the Samoan Bloodline.
Yeah
the Patriot. Hogan comes out and then somehow also comes out as the Patriot.
He was Mr. America.
Mr. America, my bad. Yeah. Whose house is this?
That would have been good.
Yeah, it's just nonsense.
Rule's house, maybe. Yes. Yeah. So that went out. I only caught the second day of it.
Hostman saying, I thought John Cena was bald for a while. Now for some reason, he looks so bad with his like. It's a comb over, dude. It's just a comb over, but it's back. Right. Instead of it being like forward or to the side, he's just combing it over back and it looks ridiculous.
Yeah.
He needs to just shave his head, male pattern baldness, and just go hardcore with it. Old man Cena.
Yeah.
Or dude, he could do the full on Chairman Mao. Just go full shave the top of the head. Everybody knows that he's in love with China.
He does love China. We all know that. He proved that to us.
His whole personality's goofy. Yeah, he should have came in riding a skateboard. I mean, the Cena thing, you know, would have worked with the American Bloodline, you know, as the decorated former U.S. veteran.
Yeah, it was a Marine, right?
Yes,
oh, no, he was in the movie.
Him, Sergeant Slaughter, all the fake Marines can join up together.
Yeah. So yeah, we want Stone Cold to come out.
This is what I really wanted to talk about, and it's probably going to be a short mention. The stream is called The Truth, and it's because R-Truth did one tag team champion.
He did one.
He won at WrestleMania, second day or first day. I didn't get to watch it, but this is true, right? R-Truth.
Yes, him and Miz won another version of the tag titles. Yeah.
The Truth. I'm excited. This is a WrestleMania moment. You know, he hasn't had one.
He's been around forever. Yes.
Is that the Miz in his space outfit over there?
Miz is from Back from the Future. You know, back
gold plated as well. His skin looks.
What the hell?
He's made of gold. Yeah. So shout out
to different about you, Miz. Oh, that's right. You're 20 feet tall and covered in solid gold.
We got Jamie East in the chat. What's up, Jamie? Good to see you, Citizen Ronan. Our truth is great. We got Vaughn Coleman. Good to see you, Vaughn. Hostman, also good to see you. Scrolling down here. Bronze in Time. Yeah, little Jimmy. Remember when R Truth had an imaginary friend?
Yeah.
Little Jimmy.
Was he invisible?
Yes. Yeah, it's good stuff. All right, enough wrestling talk.
Snarticom lost interest in WWE when Vince left.
It wasn't that long ago.
Come on out, you rapist.
Yeah, I think Vince should have came out and chokeslammed Undertaker after that.
Chokeslammed Undertaker?
You saw the last time Vince took a bump. He nearly killed himself.
I know, dude. That was a couple of years ago. That stunner?
Yeah, that was awful. That's why he didn't bring Stone Cold back. That botched stunner.
All right, shout outs to... Now, this is the first link I saw. And I know there's an Indiegogo. There's also an Indiegogo for this. Mike Barron, Kelsey Shannon doing Nexus Scourge. I think he's on all platforms. So if you guys have IGG links, you want to throw them in the chat. I think he's
gross.
I think he's past 10K. I could be wrong, but he's creeping on the Indiegogo. But he's already got 6K on the Kickstarter too. Smart, doing all, covering all platforms, and beautiful Kelsey Shannon work.
Yeah, artwork looks sick. Kelsey's killing it.
He's at like that cover. Yeah, he's at 12K on Indiegogo.
Amazing. So wherever you guys want to shop, go grab this book.
Get it.
Cosmic superhero stuff. Go grab this. Really classic storytelling as well. Colored, inked, drawn all by Kelsey. And I think they have like a little homage to Silver Surfer. It's like a chrome character on a surfboard. And I think that's the dot right there. So
yeah, but the difference is that he's a guy.
Now. Right, yeah. I don't, maybe.
Yeah, no female representation here.
I mean, you can't really tell.
It is legally distinct, though.
Right, yeah. From the
Silver Surfer. No, there's a shot in the trailer of the character. Look at this trailer. Crazy cool.
The entire Kelsey stuff is
crazy.
I don't know if Kelsey put this together. I know he's been doing a lot of animation stuff, but it's got a cool voiceover. You guys could watch it. I'm just trying to look for this.
Sorry, Snarticon. I'm sorry.
What's he yelling at you about?
He's saying books on time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, is that it? That's a guy. Look at this.
Right. Yeah.
Wait, this is legally distinct.
Right. It's completely different from the Silver Surfer that we know today.
It's actually cool design.
He's in the clear.
Yeah, it checks out.
It's pretty cool. I think there was another shot of him somewhere flying around.
That's
there he is.
Crazy. That hand coming closer to the screen.
Yeah, pretty wicked.
That's so really cool.
Check that out. Mods, if you could drop links in the chat as well. Also, links to all of our stuff are in the description. We'll talk about them as the show goes on. But yeah, shout outs to Kelsey and Mike putting in the hard work.
Jav Styler is asking who signs it. Do you know who is signing the signers?
I don't know. Let me see if I can find out. Probably Mike.
Yeah.
Let's see. Nexus Scourge Signature Series will be autographed and graded. It doesn't say. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. It will be signed.
I think it'd be hard to get Kelsey.
Let's assume Mike.
Yeah.
Oh, they're saying Alan says his name might be the Chrome Boogie Boarder.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. That could work.
The Platinum Border Rider?
Border Rider.
Maybe. Croft. But check it out.
He just knows how to derail streams, doesn't he, with his comments? Just completely just...
Bankrupt. Daily, I'm back on Fun My Comic. Awesome. Cyber Surfer? That's
a cool name. There we go, see? We more like Sinister and Ronin background.
The Silver Smurfer. Interesting. I think we'll pass on that one, though.
The White Gold Ironing Border.
It's a little long.
But, yeah, you know. I feel like white gold, you know, is not capitalized on as much as silver is, you know, in the comic book world. White gold is being, you know, it's been missed out.
All right, other news. Adam Miller with his awesome, speaking of campaigns, his Fun My Comic campaign. You guys have voted, everybody that was a backer on the campaign. I guess this was the last poll. Please pick which of these characters you'd like to see included in the Iron Age card set. So he had, she was pulled from the set, and then he did a contest, basically a tournament. You guys chose who was the winner and who he would draw to be part of the set. It was between the Patriarch, Siamese, Chiron Mor-Vell, or Aislinn from some awesome creators, Dojo Kun, Fisk, Robert Geronimo, and John from John's Long Box. And the winner is the dude from Blood Realm, which is a very hard name to say, but pretty awesome. He's got that awesome armor, iconic. Blood Realm's been going for a bunch of issues now. So shout outs to Robert Geronimo. Can't wait to see Adam Miller draw this. It's going to be pretty sweet. And if you guys, where's this poll? You had to back this set. And then he did the polls in the update section on the campaign after you backed it. So if you didn't back it, you didn't have access to those. So people that backed were able to vote. So shout outs to all the backers. And if you guys have not yet gotten this campaign too, the Iron Age Icons cards look incredible.
Hell yeah, man. It's going to be a sick project.
Reminds me of Shovel Knight. Yeah, kind of with the helmet. Much taller, though.
Yeah, I always think of those conjoined twins in the jar.
Oh, like, when someone says Siamese?
Yeah. And then I remember the king and I because of Siam.
Right, he's the king of Siam.
Well, the king was the king of Siam. Yeah.
Yeah. I remember the "We Are Siamese, if you please."
Do you remember that also?
That was the Lady and the Tramp movie.
I don't know. I just remember that song.
Yeah, it was the same cat that was in Aristocats.
Was it? I liked him better in Aristocats.
Well, he was that Chinese cat.
Yeah,
he was playing chopsticks with chopsticks.
Mm-hmm.
That movie's good. I enjoyed it. I don't even like cats. That's a good movie.
Yeah, I just don't like cats. Yeah.
Yeah, cats are.
Yeah.
When you go like this to them, then they just look at you and then walk away.
Yeah, we had
to. Want you to come over here anyway.
Yeah, and they're always scurrying around. Man, that's why we don't let people that have cats on the hard line. You know what I'm saying? Mm.
Oh, Asian Cody Rhodes, the Siamese dream.
Bancroft come up with some new characters in the chat. He says, I have a new character called Blood Bone Man.
Blood
Bone. You know, there are lawyers in Australia, Bancroft.
Well, Blood Bone Man is a lawyer. That's what he didn't tell you.
He's the lawyer. Yeah, if you don't use Blood Bone Man, we're both losing money.
Dude, Jay Ryan, he's right. Cats are the blind. To
get a critical blast to send a cease and desist over to Bancroft. He's got his address.
It's true. Cats are the blondes of the pet
world. Yeah, I agree with you, Jay Ryan.
I do have a rejected cover from Bloodbone that I can sell to Mike.
Oh, yeah. You just oh,
yeah. How are you going to do me like that live on stream?
Hey, after I defended $20 is $20.
After I defended you against your wife's attacks on stream.
Oh, yeah. Look, his name's Harvey Bloodboneman.
That's terrible.
There you go. 117 in the chat right now. Appreciate you guys being here. Let's see anyone on Rumble. If you guys have anything to say, say it now.
Because
I'm looking at the chat right now.
This is the one time he'll look at the chat.
You can chat how terrible Bancroft is at naming characters. You can talk about how terrible Phil's drawing is. You can talk about how Shelby has betrayed one of his number one supporters. Talk about how Brandon needs to draw more sexy chicks, and you talk about how you can kick Chimera. So you can hit all the topics we discuss this hour.
One thing the whole show.
I know.
Too much positivity going on this year for me. I had to rough it up.
I did get a message from someone here.
I'm assuming that was you, Brandon, muting me.
Yeah, I said it. I announced it. I said I'm going to mute his mic, and then I did it.
I wasn't paying.
all right, we got some food news, guys. Food news. It's been a while.
There's one thing I can do.
Now, is Brandon,
food news?
Let everybody know that this relates to food news. We go to the gym, right?
Yeah.
And then we come out of the gym when we're done and we go to the office. Let the chat know what you do when you get back to the office after the gym.
I imagine he's referring to the cheese. So I go in the refrigerator and I got this giant block of sharp cheddar cheese. I go in, I probably cut maybe just over an inch block off of it. And I just straight up eat it. It's so, so good.
Every day.
Just about every day. Unless every day I don't have any cheese.
So I have to watch this guy eat this cheese every day.
Yeah, it's right. Ceremonial.
Can you see if someone else has touched the cheese block? Like, can you tell like that it's not in the same spot?
Yeah, I have. It's covered in gold paint, just like Unaxinamun from The Mummy. So if their gold paint is disturbed, I just hunt down the guy with the gold paint on his hands.
Yeah, but that's the laborious thing. Afterwards, he has to repaint it with the gold paint after he's touched it.
Right, that's okay. I'm the one who's touching it.
Jay Ryan says, cheese is so good, though. I don't see the problem.
Right. I do, yeah. I have this knife, and I cut the cheese.
It's disturbing.
So good.
So I said, you know, what if you're feeling a little sweet tooth action, right?
I'm trying to stay away from that. So the cheese, you know, I'm satisfying it with the hankering for a hunk of cheddar.
Yeah. So check this out. You could satiate both of your appetites with chocolate and cheese.
I feel like this is going to fly right through you.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't even see the grill marks. They didn't even simulate the grill marks. You know, when you go get a hot dog from certain restaurants and stuff, and then they just draw the grill marks on with a marker. They didn't even do that here.
Yeah. I'm not a big grilled cheese fan.
And this is probably, it's not even real cheese. It's probably hydrogenated vegetable oil with some orange coloring.
Sorry, Dale A.
That stuff that they make people in Philadelphia eat.
Yeah, city of brotherly love. We got Pablo Romero in the chat. What's up? Good to see you. Admiral Wang.
Dude, I've been seeing, there's this page
Yeah.
And it's making me big jealous because there's this page that I follow, and it's like Pulp Hotties cover art or something like that. And he's been posting Pablo's art and some of the new art that he's been making, like these new acrylic paintings, these bikini babes. And I'm like, damn, Pablo's getting out there. That kicks ass. I wish this guy would post my art, but I'm just a lowly guy who draws bikini babes on the internet. But yeah, it's awesome seeing Pablo's stuff get out there.
Yeah, Pablo's a badass. You should look for the Richard Harrison Kit Kat.
Richard Harrison Kit Kat. Velveeta Gushers. Yeah. Oh my
God, stop it.
Yeah, you want to die? There you go.
Yes.
All right. I hate that. Speaking of Alan in the chat, he sent me this, our on the scene correspondent. We have more.
Mercy. I see this also. Yeah, he sent this to me.
Arby's beef and cheddar Letterman jacket at the head of its class.
Is this real?
I think so. It's from Arby's. Yeah, look at that.
Yeah.
I'm going to buy two of them.
Arby's posted a tribute.
Dude, you could be head of the class.
It says a tribute to Arby's classic beef and cheddar. The Arby's Letterman jacket is the ultimate prize for discerning Arby's fans.
That's cool. With the A, they'll say that you're head of the ass.
Oh my God.
I'm buying that.
So all you Arby's fans, go get it. Do they have
it's an auction. It's an auction only.
No, it isn't.
Plus, Spooky Dookie says, no, I would like never take this off.
Oh, it is already over.
Yeah,
damn it. Over, man.
Oh, I thought that meant 2028.
God, night ruined.
Yeah, thanks, sorry Bill. About that. I'm sorry. Blame Alan.
Cheesecake Kit Kat.
Ooh, that would be good.
Mm.
That's true. That's true.
These all sound fantastic.
Cheesecake would be good. The same guy that forgot his glasses for the solar eclipse at the office, he went blind because of Arby's one time.
Yeah, tell that story.
He had Arby's had this, I forget what they were calling it, but it was that, what is it called? I can't even remember what it's called. But it's like the French fries, and then they put the cheese and the gravy and all that stuff on it. That Canadian stuff, poutine is what it was. They had a poutine thing at Arby's with the curly fries and stuff. And he said it was so salty and it literally made him blind. He had to go home.
Yeah. We always joke about it. How is the curly fry?
The curly fry got stuck in his eye.
Burrowed into his eye.
The poutine. Yeah.
Amazing.
Would you guys make fun of me if I wore an Arby's employee women's coat?
Women's coat?
Yeah, that's all I can find.
It's an employee jacket?
It's an employee jacket, yeah. You wouldn't make fun of me, right?
No. Of course not.
Okay, good.
Very accepting you.
Ptomaine poisoning? Ptomaine? Yeah, I don't know what blinded him, but he drinks like 5 coffees a day. I'm talking like large coffees. So he's just teetering on the edge of being blind already.
Yeah, he also drinks a lot of Diet Dr. Peppers, right?
Yeah. Yeah. And he derides my seed oil talk. He's like, we're all going to die sometime. Like, well, I'm not going to be blind when I die, dude.
It's true.
Did you guys go out and look at, did you guys look at the eclipse today?
Yeah.
That's why we've been talking about it the whole time.
You're all fools.
You didn't.
We did too, actually. No, of course we did. We're idiots.
Stupid idiot.
Yeah, my whole classroom, we all went out. This is the crazy thing. We went out, and I don't know what it looked like there out here. It was no blue in the sky. It looked like overcast, but there was no clouds. And it was just like a grayish blue. It was like not. It wasn't blue, but it was like gray.
It was a cool gray.
Yeah, it wasn't really cooler. It's always hot here. But
everyone's trying to look and look with their phone and they can't really see anything, you know, so we're just kind of hanging out. And these girls come up, start handing out these glasses for all of us, and they're from Sonic. Sonic was giving out these glasses for the eclipse. I was like, oh, this is interesting. So we were all just rocking our Sonic glasses, looking at the black dot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sonic the Hedgehog?
No, Sonic, where I eat my hot dogs.
You know, where you get those mini corn dogs and then you dip them in your slush?
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. I thought you meant the little blue guy that eats chili dogs.
Cranberry, they worked hella good. And I was really surprised because, you know, they were just freebies. They worked good, like crazy good. I was really surprised. I honestly thought I was going to look up and lose an eyeball and then I could go home.
Should have seen these. Did you see the glasses that T-Mobile was giving away?
No.
Let me go get them. Hold on.
Yeah, I didn't think we were actually going to be going out today, but...
What's up, Wolfer?
Things happen.
Good to see you. Sonic Boom. Where'd Brandon go?
I'll take out some glasses.
Get to take a dump.
He got tired of me.
Too much cheese Kit Kats.
What do you guys want to talk about?
Arby's women's jackets and how you shouldn't make fun of me. They have three of them available. Two of them are brand new. All right, I guess we're not talking about that. Fine.
These were free. They came in this bag.
From Sonic?
Yeah.
Yes,
except they spell with a T and they call the company T-Mobile.
So from Sonic.
They're these glasses. I can't see anything.
Wow. Dude, they're for the eclipse.
So,
dude, T-Mobile got some money, huh?
And they're free.
Free glasses.
Well, you guys are welcome. I overpay my cell bill every month.
When 2045 comes around, we're picking up chicks like crazy with these things. They're like, you ever seen an eclipse before? Didn't think so.
Yeah, you better hold on to those. Put it in one of those like time capsules and bury it in the backyard.
I'm going to get a Tupperware container and fill it with water and put these in there and then put it in the freezer.
You have to break it out, though, when it happens.
Well, you can just let the ice melt. You know what's really trash about these, though, is these. I'm sure they had these glasses like from some other promo, and then they put this clip-on bit on here, which is this, and just a clip-on thing. And this, I don't know if you could see how crappy this is here. It's just like chewed out, like a rat chewed this out. It's so bad.
Oh, yeah. It's like Dremeled out?
Yeah.
That's weird.
That's terrible. You should send me those. I can wear them with my new jacket that I just got off.
Yeah, you get the your Arby's woman's jacket, man. You'd be super fly with these.
I definitely.
Nobody's going to be calling you Jive.
All right. Who's the babe of the week? Sydney Sweeney?
No, the other one won.
Who?
No, Sydney Sweeney undefeated.
Yeah, Sweeney won. Hey, there's like five new photos that dropped this week, too. So, so I've heard. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at this. Jamie's saying that glasses do not allow you to just pick up random chicks.
That's not true.
That's not true.
That's not true.
There's plenty of films out there where you can get some enchanted sunglasses that make you irresistible to the babes.
I agree. All right, before we get into Babe of the Week, update on Lost Pages. Books should probably be here Friday. They said they were going to come in on the 12th. And I think that's the 12th, right, Bryn? I can't open my calendar here.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's going to be awesome. So fulfillment going to start ASAP. Can't wait for that. Tasty Mint, Camara, how's Tasty Mint going?
Good. We're almost done with all the pencils, and I'll be launching on Bancroft's Sunday at 9 Eastern.
This Sunday?
Yeah, this upcoming Sunday.
What?
Oh, I'll be at the convention.
Yeah, no one told me this.
Everybody's going to be at Exotica. Nobody's going to be available to watch the stream.
That's awesome.
I'll take a hit for the hardline. I'll watch the stream.
Okay. Thank you.
Testament 3, guys. You better be signed up. What do you get for signing up?
Metal trading card by some guy named Shelby Roberts.
Shelby, good, man.
Up and comer.
Look at that. Awesome trading card. So you guys better be signed up. Sign up now. The link is in the description. If some mods could throw it into the chat.
Yep.
And then we also have the Ace Volume 3. Sign up is up as well.
So I got to sign up. Get ready. It's coming.
Yeah, I know a lot of progress has been made on this bad boy too.
Oh, yeah. Looking great. I was coloring up the epilogue and we'll be done with all the colors of the book. So.
Dude, this super hyena cool guy looks like he wants pictures of Spider-Man.
So do it. Give them to me now. Damn it.
Bring me pictures of Spider-Man.
So good. Yeah, awesome that you guys are getting a lot of this stuff done ahead of time. You're going to be launching with a good amount of these projects completed. So sign up if you guys haven't. Some quality books. And
I got some more blood bones over the weekend. It's going a little slower than I wanted to, you know, real life sometimes get in the way, but
definitely
I'll be packing up some more, trying to get them out to you. So
sweet. My blood bone attorney at law.
Blood bone's coming. I know some people already got them. So feel free to post pictures and let everybody know it's coming.
Awesome. So this Snarkticon tagged us in this, Brent. Did you see this?
Clearly.
He dug up the hippie girl Instagram.
Yeah.
We did a poll about the best PSYOP, and the hippie girl was probably in last place. I don't remember for certain.
Yeah, but easily she was in last place.
But we're gonna go with the hippie girl this week. For Babe of the Week.
Oh my God.
Going up against Sydney Sweeney.
You're just advancing the Sydney Sweeney agenda. That's all you're doing.
What do you mean? Look at, she's hanging out with a sloth here.
I guess.
The world's laziest.
Like she's a sloth.
Hey, now.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out which one is the sloth again.
Oh my God.
One of them's name is Sid.
All right, which Sydney Sweeney should I go with here? She's got a few different. We got the Disney.
Dude, Tom's going to Disney right now. What if he runs into her?
Oh, that'd be crazy.
That'd be all over.
Look, she's quirky, just like Bancroft.
What? Hold it. Hold it. Hold it.
We got a $20 super chat from Bite Me.
Bite Me.
Can't wait to see you guys at C2E2. Rock on. This is my donation to fly out Shelby and Kelsey.
And Kelsey? Jesus Christ. Shelby, you coming?
$20. And, you know, we might be able to make
it. I told you I'm going to go, but not tell any of you. And I'm going to take a photo from far away.
Yeah, you're going to be dressed as Bigfoot.
Yeah, I'm going to post
it. Look out for Bigfoot, guys.
I'm going to tag you in it. You guys gonna be like, "Oh shit, Shelby's here," and I'm already gonna be downstairs eating food while you guys are working hard.
Yeah, you'll be at the local Sonic.
Oh, good. No, he'll be dressed as Sonic. That's the whole thing.
He'll be Arby's girls uniform on. We won't be able to recognize him.
You can share my screen. Look what I found.
Hold on. Shout out to Bite Me. It was Bite Me's first super chat on a live stream. Appreciate it.
Look.
All right.
That's that Arby's jacket. Look how much that thing sold for.
Mega bus.
$2,200.
Yep. Yeah, worth every penny.
That's a little much there.
Mega bus has $1 tickets. I was thinking Ghani and Air. Damn. But, I mean,
Shelby,
$1 tickets, dude.
$1. We'll give you $10 if you take the
Megabus. No, you're trying to get me to go on one of those planes that fall apart in the air, dude. I know what you're doing.
That's why I chose Gani in air.
We'll take the Megabus. We'll get you. We'll give you $10. Give Kelsey another $10. You guys will both Megabus
it. Dude, you could rent out 20 seats on this bus, dude.
And you could stay at my place. We're going to be there all weekend, and you could hang out.
Come out a week or 2 weeks early, and you could come to Exotica and hang out with me at the booth.
That's this week.
I'm not out for that.
There you go.
That's Friday. Oh, wait.
See, ruined another thing, man. I wanted to go to that. I'm not getting my jacket. I'm missing out on Exotica. What else? You want me to die? You want me to die in an airplane?
That's true. How long has Sim been in the bag?
Hello, Sherry. We met again. Is it fate? Is it meant to be? Is it written in the stars that we are destined to fraternize? I'd like to think so.
About 15-20 minutes.
20 minutes?
There's no way.
About 15-20 minutes, yeah.
Oh, my God. Man,
I didn't even notice.
I know. I figured that out. I even wrote Tasty Mint and shared the link when you asked.
Thank you. Oh,
thank you.
All right, let's get back. Yeah. You came just in time for Sydney Sweeney, Babe of the Week. What are we?
All right, sorry, I was a bit late. I was making tacos.
It's okay.
Tacos.
Oh, she's got a wet shirt.
What kind of tacos?
You could say spicy sausages, tacos with potatoes, cheese, and I forgot what's the name of that little green thing that we put in there. But yeah.
I love how the first comment says, "You support where kids get kidnapped and go missing." Holy shit. That's brutal.
The Oompa Loompas are two kids that disappeared.
Oh.
Man.
Instagram is fucking awesome.
Instagram is out of control.
Can you scroll down? I want to see more.
You know, hold on. Not too long ago, I saw them share like her working on the car. That should have been one that you should pull.
She's a psyop.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we gotta look at that TikTok that she has.
Yeah.
All right, so she's going up against Shannon Blake, who is this hippie girl for Babe of the Week. We're gonna start the poll. You guys could only vote for Babe of the Week on YouTube. So if you guys are watching from Twitter or Rumble, you got to come over to YouTube for Babe of the Week. It is Sydney Sweeney, the reigning champion.
Who's probably still going to get my vote?
Hippie chick. What'd you say, Sam?
She's probably going to still get my vote. I've been voting for her every time now.
That's okay.
You're swaying the chat.
Sway. Look at this hippie chick, though. She's got like weird topographical butt.
Yeah, those are hives. Or they call them lesions.
There's hives on her butt.
Something's going on there.
She's going to be the next Silver Surfer.
Mm-hmm. It's like the movie Philadelphia.
Her chrome.
Her ass looks like it's fake, though.
Chrome
is. Yeah, someone says that in the comments. Why?
If she has a fake butt, disavow.
It's filled with aloe cream, so it's still biological.
What kind of ice cream?
Aloe.
You disavow fake butt?
I'm going to disavow bad.
Oh my god.
Phil, bring up that meme of her that I sent you earlier.
When did you send that?
I'm just kidding. Don't bring it up.
Oh, okay.
Bob was disavowing tattoos.
No tattoos? All right. We'll go back to Sydney Sweeney.
Cranberry Langer's saying, is this personality plus looks or just looks? I would say it's both. However you feel, you know, categorizing these women. You know, for me, I like objectifying.
Look how quirky she is.
Probably the way to go here in this situation.
Look at that.
Yeah, she looks
like. What did they have without pulling their thongs out? Like it's an anime thing. I don't know. They're all doing that. Isn't that supposed to mean something there?
Yeah, they're all part of the cover. She's covering one eye. She's part of the Illuminati.
Sorry. Okay.
Fuck. She's part of the cult.
No, I'm even seeing girls I know on fucking Facebook going on a trip and doing that same face with the pulled tongue there. And I'm like, what the fuck's going on?
The third eye right there. Illuminati. Look at this. Confirmed.
Wait, go back to the one where she has red hair. Yeah.
Is this one, is she's being puppeted by the government? She's being
puppeted, dude. The part of the Illuminati is that they have to publicly show what's going on with them, right? They have to announce it, but without actually saying it directly. And this is exactly what's going on there. Mm-hmm. Look at, she's praising the one. She recognizes the tribal chief.
No, but she loves Disney.
That's actually more.
Are you trying? What you doing?
It's right in your face, Phil. How could you not?
You're kind of confirming exactly what he's saying, you know? But it's where is the mouse?
The mouse?
Is the mouse. Yes.
The mouse.
See, Pablo gets it. I objectify because I'm an artist. Everyone is an object for me. Huh. Pablo knows his score.
She's filming that Cocoon movie.
Yeah. She's a pod person.
Not a pod person.
So are we trying to
see, this is exactly some person is part of the Illuminati. Illuminati disbanded in the 90s and an Anunnaki left. That's exactly what they want you to think. The person's in on it.
I still voted for her. You know.
What is this person a part of then?
She's counter.
She's a reptilian. A
opposition.
She's reptilian for sure.
The lizard person?
Yeah. She's probably the person Gomez was looking at in the plane.
Like, she's too into makeup and everything to actually be a hippie. So she's a dry up hippie.
I guarantee you she eats better foods than Sydney, though.
They don't count.
And then she follows it up with a giant bong rip.
Yeah, she probably just eats leaves.
Snarktagon hates them both. Sydney's hoarding chromosomes for who? For herself?
Yeah, they're saying that she's Down syndrome.
Amazing.
She's the hot version of Greta Thunberg.
That's what I was going to say too.
God.
The sexiest version, yeah. Gross. And it's not so much.
All right, we're going to keep this open for another minute. We already got 20 votes. It's good. Keep voting, guys.
You know, they both eat baby.
No.
I'm put off by both ladies. Yeah, do you remember when we had Salma Hayek as Babe of the Week?
We just watched Desperado last
night. We watched Desperado yesterday for the first time.
Really? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we were basically at gunpoint.
You've never seen it before?
Yeah, we couldn't believe we were forced to watch Desperado.
But I enjoyed it.
And we didn't even watch El Mariachi. End.
Huh?
We didn't even watch El Mariachi.
That's fine. I love the intro.
That's fine. Yeah, the intro is hilarious. But as an object, Selma Hayek is great looking. Until the very end, when the Robert Rodriguez-isms came out, and the guys had their weapons were the guitar cases.
Yeah, that was
instead
good.
Of the stuff in the guitar cases, and the guy's rocket launcher guitar case was too much.
That's kind of was
incredible.
That was too much. That, the rocket
that
was, launcher.
That's what made the movie.
That's the best part. That was the best part.
Yeah, Iglesias in there or something. What's his name? The kid.
The kid?
Yeah, that was a young Enrique Iglesias.
He's in there. Yeah, the one. Yeah.
He's in the third one, I think.
The one with the bazooka. No, he's in the second one. He's the second when the two extra mariachi come out.
That's not Enrique Iglesias. He's in the third one.
Yes, it is.
No, they did some crazy stuff in that.
You have the original El Mariachi, and you have Enrique Iglesias.
Fat Selena Gomez.
And the one that blows himself up, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, see, Enrique's in the third one, Cicerone says. That's when they got all the big stars, like Mickey Rourke.
Johnny Depp.
Johnson Depp.
All right, I did notice, though, that Selma Hayek's accent has gotten worse and stronger over the years. Instead of, you know, her living in the United States, and it would get weaker and weaker
Yeah. Yeah.
Gotten stronger.
Oh, maybe you're right. Maybe I'm mistaken. That was in the second.
What do you have to sell here, Sim?
Tesla and Adverse 2. Actually, I'm aiming to go to print by the end of the month. Right now, I'm just finalizing the. I added two more pages. I'm waiting for them to get colored because I just thought there was two pages missing there. And the lettering's getting done, so we're going to print by the end of the month.
Awesome.
Going to be closing the campaign pretty soon.
That's good to hear. You can drop your link in the chat.
Cranberry Lingers thinks what's her face is hot.
Who?
Yeah.
From the Mask of Zorro.
I never seen it.
Jones.
What else, Charo?
Charo's still alive.
Jones? Maybe. I never seen it. Get them all right, look.
The poll is over. 75% said Sydney Sweeney wins.
75% of the people didn't vote.
Beat down Sydney.
Okay, calm down.
It was a massacre. Brandon Psyops failed once again, guys.
What if these
Sweeney rocks?
The Psyops won.
What if there's a government interference with this vote? The Psyop doesn't let it change hands.
Ooh, they killed Charo?
Charo's not dead. Yeah,
not to say.
I didn't know she was sick.
She sounds dead.
She's not dead, I don't think. Charo, not Churro? Who's the chick from Love Boat?
Charo, Spanish actress.
Yeah, she's alive. She's alive.
Angela Curry says, can we pick someone I'd rather vote for than Sweeney? Yeah, no.
She's alive and 73 years old. No.
This is not until episode 200. We're going to ride the Sweeney train.
Send me your suggestions.
Remember when you had those murderers on for Halloween?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the only thing Angela cares about is the murderers.
Yeah. Can't wait for her to bring them back.
Mm. Well, guys, it's been good. Everybody subbed
to moderate
stream. No B. Arthur. She's
I
gross.
Can't imagine B. Arthur ever being hot.
Yeah, some people aren't.
Yeah, it happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, you could sponsor a submission. It's only $10.
Yeah, just PayPal Shelby Robertson $20. And
for my
to fill. Yeah. To get that airfare up, guys. You want to see you want to see Shelby at C2E2? You got a couple more $20 super chats I'll have to do.
We did Angela White the other day. Yeah. Nominated Angela.
Phil, that's great. Phil, what? Look in there. Look in private, Phil.
All right, I'm looking.
I like being a contrarian and proving people wrong.
I see what he's talking about.
Oh, like, oh, yeah.
He's proving my point.
Is that the Golden Girls?
Shelby's personal photo.
No, leave it up.
To each their own fetish, I guess.
Yeah, we know what's in the Shelby spank bag now. It's on this Dropbox.
Pablo, we did Angela White a couple weeks ago. Rob Arnold suggested it.
That one's on loan from Zuck.
We had a Rumble chat. Kirby was over there. He says, test, Phil, show that drawing with the dude with the knife and the eyes like two balls. You have to go back and watch it yourself.
He's coming at puke. He's gonna puke. He's gonna puke. He's gonna puke. He's gonna puke.
Well, we're joined at the last second by Ball Long Chang.
Long Chang Chang. The last second, I was here to get this party started. What?
We're closing it down.
Rob, no, the show just started. You're just messing with me.
Yeah, we got another hour to go. You're not a Joe Ball for your party.
The in the chat. Gordon Goodbrother, go look her up on Google Images.
Don't end the stream. We got all night.
Oh, my God. I have to take a shower.
Ending the 3-hour Hardline stream. See, so see what you created, Phil. This is your monster.
Now they're used to it.
This is what, so you started.
Everybody sub to Shelby's channel and watch him draw something this week.
Yeah, I'll be drawing this week.
Cool. And
yes, Brandon, you should always be drawing.
Yeah, I should always be drawing. I like to draw while I'm at the convention. I was thinking of doing a thing. It's all just
yearly drawing done in one night.
Yeah, I do it all at the convention right there while I'm at the show.
I like to drink at the convention myself. But that's
dude, that's whack ass, man. He goes in there and he's got this backpack full of God knows what. And he's walking around and he's swigging and hitting on girls and everything. And yeah, you got to drag his corpse out.
Like a good time.
Whack ass rolls.
Yeah, he's a pimp. He's a pimp. All right. I'm going to end the stream, guys. All
right.
Have a great day. Friday, I'll be streaming Diaz Brothers show with a special guest since Brandon's not going to be there. Tune in to see who it is.
Special ghost.
It's not me. You didn't invite me.
Yeah, it's not Shelby. It might be Shelby. Who knows?
Oh, we have a question here.
All right.
Some person says, and this is directly to Phil, will you eventually interview Bisley on stream? It'd be interesting hearing the whole story when he worked for Alan Moore. And then in his own voice, too. You could dress up like Simon also, right? And you could do the Simon voice that you do.
Uh-huh.
And it would be like a Saturday Night Live bit, you know? Where, like, they have the actual guy come on.
Yeah, we do, like, a Simon and Simon show.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I'll probably be hearing from him in the next couple of days because he has the books that he's signing for The Lost Pages 3. So he should be sending them back this week. Yeah, I'll ask him.
Yeah, Alba. Dude, you remember when I asked Jeremiah about Jessica Biel today and he said she was overrated as hotness?
Yeah. Oh, she's hot.
I think she's underrated as hot.
Yep.
He's out of his
mind. She won't be Arthur, but she's all right.
Who is B. Arthur, right?
Yeah.
But. I wish I didn't know. All right, guys. We'll see you Friday. Peace out.
See you.
See ya.
Peace.
I'm gonna get these pigs here. Here we go.